entering the human kidney and cutting open a glomerular, we can see that capillary loops are completely wrapped by the visceral epithelial cells. To cut open a section of a capillary loop, we can see that the capillary wall is divided into three layers. The outermost layer is the podocyte layer, the middle is the basement membrane layer, and the innermost layer is the endothelial layer. The endothelial layer, which is shown in front of us, is composed of a series of flattened, slightly long, perigenal, sieve-shaped endothelial cells. The cells are closely connected together by the lamina. On the surface of endothelial cells, we can see that a lot of 60 to 80 nanometer round or oval holes, which are called window holes. Under the electron microscope, we can also see that the outer surface of the endothelial cells is surrounded by a layer of glycoprotein with a negative charge, such as sialic acid protein. The window holes on the surface of endothelial cells, the connections between cells, and the surface chloroprotein layers together constitute the first layer of glomerular capillary filtration barrier, which can intercept substances with a negative charge, various plasma micromolecules, and blood cell composition into the blood vessels. Only a small amount of micromolecule protein and metabolic waste such as creatinine can go into Bowman space while endothelial cells, basement membrane, and the visceral epithelial cells and then be passed out via urine. In summary, the endothelial cells can maintain normal hemodynamics in the glomeruli and play an important role in the formation and repair of glomerular filtration barriers.
Dear friends, here is nephrologist online video consultation of Beijing Tongshantang Hospital of Traditional Chinese Medicine. I'm the host, Austin. Welcome to the live broadcast, and let us welcome our professor Mao Yan to introduce the knowledge for us.
大家好，我们今天主要讲的题目还是肾颜色什么病。
The topic we are talking about today is what is nephritis.
首先呢，我们要了解肾炎是个什么病。
First of all, we need to understand what the kind of disease is nephritis.
肾炎呢是肾脏的固有细胞病，是由于人体内和人体外的毒素呢，导致肾脏的五大固有细胞功能受到了损伤，引起不同程度的肾脏功能的减退的一组肾脏固有细胞疾病。可由多种病因引起，在慢性过程中呢，也有非免疫性的、非炎症的机制参与。由于本属疾病的病理类型以及病期不同，主要临床表现呢，各个阶段呢也不同，疾病的表现呢也呈多样化。
Nephritis is an intrinsic cell disease of the kidney.It is a group of renal intrinsic cell disease showing varying degrees of renal dysfunction, manifesting damage to the five major intrinsic functional cells of kidney caused by toxins in and out of the human body, which can be caused by various etiology. There are also non-immune, non-inflammatory mechanisms involved in the chronic process. Due to the different pathological pattern and different stage of the disease, the main clinical manifestation are different. The disease manifestation are diversified.
这个全球呢，约有呢10%的成年人呢患有肺炎。全球各地的慢性肺炎呢，发病率也是不一。其中呢，沙特阿拉伯和比利时呢，这个慢性肺炎的发病率是比较高的，它为24%。而挪威呢和荷兰的慢性肾脏病发病率就比较低。美国呢，慢性肾脏病呢为14%。据中国首次呢肾脏病流血病学的调查报告显示，中国慢性肾脏病总发病率为10.8%。
About 10% of adults worldwide have nephritis, and the incidence of chronic nephritis varies from place to place. Among them, the incidence of chronic kidney disease in Saudi Arabia and Belgium is the highest, at 24%. The incidence of chronic kidney disease in Norway and in Netherlands is the lowest, at 5%. The incidence of chronic kidney disease in the United States is 50%. According to China's first epidemiological survey of nephropathy, it shows the overall incidence of chronic kidney disease in China is 10.8%.
肺炎呢是一种就是说进展性疾病，起病后呢病情呢慢慢的迁延，就是说缓慢的进展，最终呢会导致慢性肾衰竭，其进展速度呢根据每个人的个体差异很大，就是说病理的类型呢为重要的因素，但也与是否重视保护肾脏啊治疗啊是否恰当以及呢避免就是说这个疾病的恶性化因素呢都有很大的关系。
Nephritis is a progressive disease that progresses after the onset and progresses slowly, eventually leading to chronic renal failure. The rate of progression varies widely from individual to individual, and the pathological type is an important factor, but it is also related to protection of the kidney, appropriate treatment, and deterioration avoiding.
肺炎的主要临床表现呢，就是说蛋白尿、血尿、水肿、高血压、肾功能异常、乏力、腰部疼痛啊、纳差、尿量呢减少，有些部分病人呢表现的少尿、充血性心力衰竭，其中呢反复发作的肉眼血尿呢和大量的蛋白尿呢，就是说导致呢血压过早的升高和肾功能过早的下降，这种情况下来讲呢是肾阳预后不良的一个主要指征。
The main clinical manifestation of nephritis: urine protein, hematuria, edema, hypertension, renal dysfunction, fatigue, waist pain, anorexia, decreased urine output. Some patients with oliguria, congestive heart failure, and so on.Recurrent gross hematuria, massive urine protein, early high blood pressure, and early renal failure are the main indications for poor prognosis of nephritis.
那血尿和蛋白尿、水肿是怎么引起来的呢？是因为人体内外毒素，就是说各种的毒素导致人体的免疫功能的紊乱。通过这些免疫就是机制的紊乱呢，就是我们就是会导致呢人体的免疫功能下降，通过免疫功能下降以后呢，就是说免疫炎症的抑制、炎症介子因子的介入以及非免疫机制等引起的本病，当内皮细胞受到损伤之后，就会导致呢红细胞漏到了尿液里面，就形成了血尿。
How is the blood in the urine, urine protein, and edema caused? It is because various toxins in and outside the body cause the immune function disorder of human body, and the disease is caused by the immune mechanism. The inflammatory mediator factor and the non-immune mechanism. When the endothelial cells are damaged, red blood cells will leak into the urine and form hematuria.
当组细胞受到损伤以后呢，组细胞纤维的蛋白和组细胞的骨架呢就会遭到破坏，导致组细胞的屏障呢受损，血浆蛋白呢就漏到尿液里面去了，形成了尿蛋白。当大量的蛋白随着尿流出那个尿液中以后呢，血浆里的蛋白的浓度呢会进一步的下降，那个胶体渗透压呢也会减少，血浆中的水肿呢就会转移到组织间隙中，从而形成了水肿。
When the podocytes are damaged, the podocyte-associated protein and the podocyte cytoskeleton are destroyed, resulting in damage to the podocyte barrier.And plasma protein leaks out into the urine to form urinary protein. When a large amount of protein is lost with the urine, the concentration of plasma protein is further decreased. The choroid osmotic pressure is reduced, and edema in the blood is transferred to the tissue space to form edema.
好的，各位朋友，这就是我们今天给大家讲的肾炎是个什么病。
Okay, my friends, this is our topic today. What is nephritis?
知道以后呢，那什么会，就是为什么会得肾炎？明天我们的直播课程呢，我们再给大家就是说进行详细的讲解。因为只有知道了病因，才能想办法怎么进行治疗。所以呢，为什么会得肾炎？这个肾炎的治疗是关键的。
After diagnosis, why do we have nephritis becomes a question. Tomorrow's live course, we will give a detailed explanation to all of you about that. Because only by knowing the cause of disease can we get the proper treatment. So knowing why nephritis occurs is the key of treating it.
感谢朋友的收看，下次再见。
Thank you for watching. See you next time.